Hey A2, our October 5th Friday is coming up this week. And this 5th Friday, we're gonna do things a little different. Instead of coming together on a Friday night as a congregation for worship and fellowship and food, we're all going to observe a Sabbath. That's right, as a church, we're going to observe a Sabbath. In fact, Pastor Chris is going to preach to us about Sabbath this Sunday, October 31st. So, I don't want to give away too much of the content that he may go over this weekend, but we do want to resource you and your family with some information and tips that you'll find helpful in observing a Sabbath this weekend for 5th Friday. So, our ultimate goal in doing this as a church is to introduce you to another spiritual discipline that will aid you in your relationship with Jesus. Sabbath is not really something that is often brought up in Protestant circles. In fact, this very well might be the first time that some of you are ever hearing about this thing that I'm calling the Sabbath. So, in case that is you, let me just do a little bit of brief background info, and then I'll cover a few practical things that you can do in order to practice Sabbath this weekend, maybe even for the very first time. So, what is the Sabbath? Sabbath is an ancient practice created by God that involves ceasing, resting, worshiping, and feasting. That's what Sabbath is. It is a day of celebration, observing the goodness of God and His work in our life. In keeping the Sabbath, you are preaching your faith in the finished work of Christ. It is a weekly reminder that we are not what we do, but we are who He says we are. We do not work for heaven, nor do we work for Sabbath. We rest every week, not because our work is done, but because He tells us in His Word that it is very good to rest, to unplug, and to have a day every week in which we slow down and stop thinking about work and remind ourselves of His love, His grace, His creation. Again, I don't want to say too much more about what the Sabbath is in this format because I want you to hear an incredible and refreshing sermon from Pastor Chris this weekend about Sabbath. But I can tell you this, church, that this simple discipline of taking a day every week to honor the Sabbath and to keep it holy can be a revolutionary and life-changing practice for your faith and your livelihood. So here's what we're gonna do. In order to promote you keeping the Sabbath every week, we want to do it as a church this week. And so here's how you can join us this 5th Friday. Observe the Sabbath. That's it. We're not gonna gather. We're not gonna worship together as a congregation and have fellowship as much as we love doing that. This time we are going to observe the Sabbath as a church. So, here's a few things that you can do to observe the Sabbath this week with your church family. The first thing you have to do is you have to usher in the Sabbath. What do I mean by that? Take a brief moment to acknowledge that the Sabbath has begun. And you can do that by involving at least 3 or 4 elements. And the first thing is by reading God's Word. So in order to usher in the Sabbath, gather either yourself or your family and read God's Word together. Genesis chapter 2, verses 1 through 3 is a great passage to read to usher in the Sabbath. So is Psalm 23. So is Psalm 90 and probably plenty other scriptures that you may enjoy reading. So start the Sabbath by reading a little bit of God's Word. The second thing that you'll want to do to start the Sabbath is to worship. So sing a worship song. Maybe there's a favorite worship song that you have that we sing as a church or that you listen to on a regular basis. Lead you and your family in a time of worship. And then the third thing you do after you read God's Word and after you worship is say a prayer. You say a prayer and you just pray to God, thanking Him for all that comes to mind and giving this Sabbath day to Him. So we pray, we worship, we read the Word, and if you wanted to go super traditional, then you could actually light 2 candles. That's the traditional way of ushering in the Sabbath. You have 2 candles, one symbolizing the ceasing of work, and the second symbolizing entering into the rest of God. So the first thing you have to do to observe the Sabbath is to usher in the Sabbath. The second thing you have to do is to enjoy a great meal. That's right. Instead of fasting on this fifth Friday, we are going to feast. Enjoy a great meal, preferably with family and or friends. Bring family over, bring friends over, and have an incredible meal that you enjoy. Eat something yummy and have a great dessert. Talk, laugh, and have a great time with one another. The third way you can observe the Sabbath is by engaging in a fulfilling activity. Engage in something that brings life to you. Maybe that's reading a book or going for a walk or going to Oak Mountain State Park, or it could be any number of things, but do something that is fulfilling to you that does not involve work, something that fills you up. And the fourth thing you can do to practice Sabbath with us this fifth Friday, and this is a really important one, church, is to unplug. That's right, you've got to unplug. I'm talking no email, no social media, and very limited, if any, usage of your phone, unless, of course, there is an emergency. That's going to help you turn your mind off to the rest of the world and really focus your attention heavenward on to God. So we hope that this resource is helpful for you and that you join us this fifth Friday by observing a Sabbath with you and your family, and then join us for worship on October 31st as we hear a sermon from Pastor Chris on observing the Sabbath. Let's do it, church. Amen and amen.